come. Oh, my Jesus. Oh, my Jesus. You are free. Come. You are anointed. If you hear me say, you are free, you are anointed, you are not the same. Come. You are blessed. Come. You are anointed. Come. You are anointed. Come. Come, sister. You are anointed. Come. Oh, my sister. Oh, my sister. Where is your husband? Why not married? Where is the husband? Eh? You are not married, eh?
No, sir.
Come. Come. You are free. Come. Oh, Jesus. Oh. Oh, Jesus. Come. Oh, my brother, you are blessed. Oh, your stomach is dry. Oh, yes. You are together. You don't know him. Oh. God wants to use this brother. So I won't leave him until. Auntie, I won't leave this brother. Thank you for raising this man. Open your eyes, look at me. Where is your church?
Sir, I don't have a church. I was praying to God that I may find mentorship from you, because I come from Durban, actually. So it's what I was asking God for, and I saw...
You were asking God for what?
For mentorship.
But what is mentorship? Just define mentorship.
I realized that doing the work alone...
Because go. Everybody can be your mentor. Even if you're not coming here, you know, I can be your mentor. You don't ask it.
Sir, you don't ask
mentorship. Everybody can be a mentor.
I realized that... I was going out just to do God's work alone, and I realized that to be alone. Eh? I realized that I was going out to do God's work alone, and I was facing many challenges. So I was inspired to pray for mentorship, because I don't have
a guide. Go and pray to get a father. You don't need a mentor. Everybody can be a mentor.
That's what
a
I
father
mean,
is a person who will reprimand you. You agree. Who will show you you agree. But mentor, you learn from him. You can just learn from that one. You learn from that one. You learn.
That's what I'm trying to say, man of God.
Huh?
That's what I'm trying to say.
You are pray for what?
For a father.
Yes. I've been also told by God that I must not just take anybody on that, on a father, on the issue of a fatherhood. I've been told that. Where is your wife?
I don't have a wife, sir.
Why?
haven't gotten a chance to marry. Eh? I haven't gotten a chance to marry.
So why don't you start to pray for a wife first before you rush to get a father?
I had one. I had somebody, but she just left me.
Eh?
I had someone that we were talking about, some serious talk, and she just left.
I know what I'm speaking with you. That's why I'm saying this.
Yes.
Yes. I say the best way for you is to pray to have a wife and first. And then you engage yourself to be in the church where you find a father. Are you not in the church?
Sorry, my brother.
Are you not in the church of someone?
No, sir.
You don't go to church?
I was in the Christ Embassy in Randburg. That's where I was fellowshipping.
So you are in Durban?
No, I'm from Durban, but I just moved here. I came in November. Moved here.
You don't pray to get the father. The father is a person who gives birth to you. He gives birth to you. If you want me to be your father, you come and sit in the church and say, I want to be a member of this church, your fellowship here. It's not like when you've got a church, it's different.
Yes, sir.
You understand? Yes, you don't have a church. You still need having a wife. You need to go to church, you sit. And then now the father will look at you. This one is called, let me take this one. They say, let me give birth to this one, just like that. But if you just go around like this, I want a father, you will never get that father. I'm sure you understand that. Am I answering some of you? So a father is a person who gives birth to you.
Yes,
a mentor is a person that you can just learn, you can even copy from him. But for you to go around and say, I want a father, I want a father, you can make mistake because you can be here. If I say you are my son now, I'll be lying to you. If I just take you and say you are my son now, you still have a problem of marriage. You still have a problem that you need to solve of marriage because this is a problem of your family.
Yes, sir.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So I'm praying for you for that problem to break. So now it's broken. You find a church of this man or of this lady and say, I want you to be which church? Okay, I want to be a member. You go and fellowship there. You serve there. When you are serving there, this person will give birth to you. Let's stop this thing of going around searching for fathers, whatever, whatever. It has also created problems to me. So I don't want to see it again. It has created a lot of, when I'm seeing you come here, you've got problems like this, I see, I want to solve that problem. Tomorrow, you change your mind. You go back to the people that you say they've attacked you. So at the end of the day, I'm the one who's jealous. So what I need now is you.
Yes.
When you don't have a church, you go around. Maybe you want me to be a father. Come to church here. Come and sit there. Come here. After 3 months when you are coming, ask for the membership. I want to feel, they will ask you how long you are here. I'm sure you understand that. And then from there you fill the form, I'm a member of Charis now. Now, when you're a member of Charis now, you wait for us to give birth to you. We give birth to you and say, this one is called. Okay. Otherwise, you will meet people who are saying, you're a man of God, you're called. Because they want you to follow them. The people are just saying, hello, sir. I'm seeing God wants to use you. You're a man of God. You're going to be used as a prophet. And from there, you follow them. You follow them. And there's no church. So what you need now, you just come here and sit down. We preach the word of God. Preach the word of God. Now you begin to learn what is happening in Charis. Now Charis has become your home. If Charis is your home, we are your parents automatically. Is it not true? But if you turn around, hey, I want a father, I want a father. What kind of father do you want? How do you know me? So that's where problem rises.
Amen.
You understand what I'm trying to say?
Yes, amen.
So this question is not good for you. It's for the people who have got a church. God bless you.
Thank you.
Can you tell us your name and where you come from?
Okay, my name is Pastor Genesis Mpisane from Randburg.
Can you tell us the prophecy you received today in the confirmation?
The man of God spoke about my calling and how God is going to use me. And he gave me advice based on my calling. And I'm really thankful for that.
And he also talked about the issue of a curse of marriage. Can you tell us also about that?
Oh, yes, I do confirm the prophecy because in my family, my mom, my father did not marry my mom. And there was a lot of challenges in marriage. In fact, not many people are successful in marriage in family. Yeah.
And he also said you should pray to have a spiritual father because there are many mentors out there. Can you also tell us what was happening?
Oh, yes. Okay. He actually made me understand the difference between a mentor and a father. So it makes sense to me now. Thank you.
So are you going to do what he has guided you to go and do?
Yes, of course. I will. Thank you.
And how are you feeling?
I'm feeling blessed today. I believe the grace of God has located me. I believe the God has used the man of God as a mouthpiece to speak to me specifically. So I'm really grateful.
And what is it that you believe that God is going to start doing in your family since today you've been prayed for to break the curse that was happening?
I believe the doors are open for marriage in Jesus' name. Amen.
Words of encouragement to the viewers all over the world?
I just want to encourage viewers around the world. Just like the man of God said, you just don't go about looking for mentorship. You need to ask God and you need to pray to God. I advise viewers out there to make the Word of God a standard for their lives, to build their lives based on the Word of God, and then to also rely on the leadership of the Holy Spirit. So, yes, yeah.